important concept is there. You people are familiar with the class and objects and methods, everything you are familiar with. Now one important thing is there, I'm going to start with its abstract class. So first of all, we need to understand what exactly the abstract class. Remember, the first important thing regarding the abstract classes in Python, we don't have abstract class. Like we are having the regular class, in Python we don't have the abstract class. Someone can tell you, no, this one is the abstract class. Suppose I am going to give the example like class A, and within this class, suppose I am going to write def, and I am just going to give the method name display, and this particular method, I am not going to do anything, I am just going to give the pass. Someone can consider this as an abstract class because we are having the method. In this particular method, nothing is there. So might be someone will consider, okay, this one is the abstract class. But remember, we cannot create the object of an abstract class. The first thing, we cannot create the object of an abstract class. And here we can create the object of this particular class. If I'm going to run z is equal to a, yeah, it's perfectly fine. As such, we don't have any error, nothing is there. Means what? You can create the object of this particular class. So this is not the example of abstract class. Number one, might be in the some tutorials and all, might be in the some videos and all, this is written over there that in Python you can create this particular way, you can create the abstract class in Python. Remember, if we can create the object of a class, that particular class is not an abstract class. This is the first thing that you need to remember. Okay. Now, remember, normally, there is two types of class. One is concrete class. Concrete class means what? Can create object. You can create the object of the class. If you can create the object, that's a concrete class. Remember, the concrete class, it contains concrete method. Concrete method means what? Method with body. Normally, when we create the class, see, this is a class. We are able to create the object of this class. So, this is a concrete class. And here, we are defining the method. Like, the method body is there. So basically what I am trying to say, concrete class means what? Can create object. Yeah. It contains the concrete method. Concrete method means what? Some body will be there, like some code will be there. Number one. Number two, we are having abstract class. In every programming language, we are having the concept of abstract class. Abstract class means what? Can't create object of that class. Can't create object of that class. We can't create the object of the concrete class. Used to inherit. This abstract class is basically used for the inherit purpose. And has to remember, will contain the abstract class will contain the abstract method. Abstract method means what? Without body. Method will be there, but there will be no any body, without body. Remember, if some class is going to inherit the abstract class, has to implement abstract method. Implement means what? Need to provide the body for that. because you need to write something with the body. It's a compulsory. If some class is going to inherit the abstract class, has to implement the abstract method. You need to provide the body for that. And if someone is going to ask you why we use abstract class, like, okay, it's a class, we can't create the object, what is the purpose, like, you can inherit that particular class, the purpose, like, what is the objective of this abstract class, what is the purpose of this? It provides us method templates. It provides us method templates or some standard method signature. Initially, I am just going to show you how to use the abstract class in Python, and after that, I will show you what is the purpose of this. Remember, directly we cannot use the abstract class in Python, but indirectly we are having certain modules is there. Using that module we can do that. So if I need to create the abstract class, the first thing that you need to do, you just need to use the library over there. I'm just going to use from ABC. ABC means the abstract class, abstract base class. From ABC, I'm just going to import ABC. And again, I need to implement the abstract method. Abstract method. So the first thing I'm going to write from ABC, import ABC and abstract base class and abstract method. Now I'm going to create a class, and that class will be the child class of ABC. So if I'm going to create a class, and if the class is going to be the part of the ABC, like it's the child class of ABC, means this one is the abstract class. Now, within the abstract class, there will be the abstract method. So I need to give the notation over there. So I'm just going to write at the rate abstract method. This is the notation for that. Like you are going to give the instruction to the interpreter that, okay, this is the abstract method. You need to define like this. I'm going to define def display. And I'm just going to write this. So this is what, this is the abstract method. How the Python interpreter is going to recognize this one is the abstract method, because you are giving the notation over there. This is the hint for the interpreter. Like it's, this is the abstract method. Now what I need to do? So this is the abstract class. Okay, let me create the object of this. A, I'm writing z is equal to A. I'm going to run this. See, we are getting the error. Cannot instantiate abstract class. We cannot do that. Okay, that's the good thing. So we cannot get the object of the abstract class. So what is the use of this? The abstract class is normally used to, abstract class is normally used to inherit. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write class B. And the B class will be the child of class here. Now I'm going to inherit this particular class A. Now it's my responsibility to give the method body for this particular method. So I'm just going to write def display self, and I'm going to give the body for this. Print like, it's an abstract method. It's an abstract method. We are giving body for that. Yeah, this thing is written over there. So now B is what? B is the child of this abstract class, and you are going to provide the body for this. And finally, I'm going to create the object of this concrete class. This one is the concrete class, this one is the abstract class. So we can create the object of this B. So I'm just going to write y is equal to B. Now I'm going to call the method y.display, run this, and we are getting the, like it's an abstract method, we are giving body. So the first thing, if someone is going to tell you how to implement the abstract class in Python, this is the example that this is how you can implement this. For that you need to write from ABC, import ABC, and you need to import the abstract method. Now I'm going to get a class. This particular class is going to be the subclass of ABC. ABC stands for abstract base class. So I'm just going to write from ABC, import ABC. I'm going to use abstract method over there. Class A, class A will be the child of ABC. Now here you need to give the notation for that. At the rate abstract method, this is the indication, like, okay, this is the abstract method. Now I am writing class B. Now B is the child of A, and I am going to provide the body for this. Suppose I am not going to give the body, then what will happen? I am not going to give the body for this. This is the different method, display one. Then what will happen? Cannot instantiate abstract class B with abstract method display. It's compulsory to provide the body for this, so I need to do that. So this is what exactly the abstract class is. No, it's perfectly fine. So this is how we can use the abstract class over there. Now my question is remains same. Okay, it's fine. Like abstract class, we can't create the object. Okay, in abstract class there must be some abstract method. Okay, the class that's going to inherit the abstract class has to provide the body for the method. It's fine. Again, but still my question is remains same. What is the purpose of this? Why I'm going to create the abstract class? Okay, I'm just going to give you the practical example. Try to understand. Suppose you people are working with my company. I'm the project manager over there, and you all are working as a developer. Okay. Now, today if someone is just put the resignation mail and just asking that today is the last day and from tomorrow I am not going to come in the company, and this is all the projects and all. They submitted me the code and all everything, and after that now he left the company. Suppose some programmer was there, and that particular programmer was working from last 1 year with the particular project. Suddenly he asked me for the resign, and now he is not there with my company. What will happen? Suppose G was writing the project. G was there with the company from 1 year, he was working with some project. Naturally, from last 1 year he was working with the project. Lot of methods are there, but he write the methods like def A. Again he write the method like def B, and so approx more than 1000 methods are there, because from last 1 year he was working and everything was smooth with the project and all. Everything was running perfectly fine. We don't have any problem. Now G left the company. What, as a manager, what I need to do? I just assign this particular project from the G. I'm just going to assign this particular project to this. Now, the T is what she need to do. She need to review the project. And I'm the manager. I'm just going to ask her, okay, do one thing. Review the project, and from tomorrow you need to start the work with the project. Now the problem is, G was working with this project from last 1 year. I'm just going to give the project to T's, and I'm asking her, like, okay, do one thing, review the project, and from tomorrow you need to start the work with the project. Suddenly there is some requirement from the client in that particular project. Now T is having the trouble. The problem is, G was writing the project. G was familiar with each and everything. He was familiar with, like, what are the content there with the method A, what are the content in there with the method B, what are the content in there with the method C. So G was familiar with, so G don't have any problem. but T is not the parameter with the methods and the content over there. The method name used by the G was not appropriate. It's a random name like A, B, C, X, Y, Z. That's the problem. Now the challenge for the T is how she can understand each and everything, the code written from last 1 year. I'm just assigning her 1 day or 2 days to review the code. She is not able to do that. And finally, she is going to show me, okay, this is the code, what I need to do. As a manager, this is really, it's a worry for me. Like from last 1 year, he was working with the code. Right now, he is not in the company. Now, some other programmer is not going to write something with their code or not able to understand the code. The problem is the nomenclature, the method standard and all. So this is the lesson for me. Today G is going to resign the company. Tomorrow some other employee will resign the company. After that again some other employee is going to resign the company. Then what I will do? What options I am having right now? The option is either we will create a new project, the same project I need to write the code each and everything. Otherwise I need to give some time to the T's, but I'm going to give some more time for T's. She is not able to understand the code because the method name was written, it was random. Like there is no any meaningful name of the methods and all. That was the problem. So as a programmer, as a manager, what I will do now from today, it's my instruction for all of you. You can't write the name of the method like this. So what you need to do as a manager, what I will do, I will create an abstract class template. I will create an abstract class. In the abstract class, I will define the method def fn export. This is the name I'm going to give. See, I'm the manager, naturally having some experience and all. So from my past experience, I'm just going to give the class. In this particular class, I'm just going to give some standard name of the methods and all. I'm just going to give the import. I'm just going to give some other method over there, fnpdf. And my instruction is, from today onwards, everyone has to implement this particular abstract class, and accordingly you need to do the work. So what will happen? G is working with another project, T is working with another project, Hermine is working with another project, but everyone has to implement the same method over there. In every project, somehow export will be there, somehow import will be there, somehow the PDF formation will be there, like printing options will be there. In every project these things will be there. So now everyone has to write the code in this particular method only. For the print, the project is different, but printing will be there. Project is different. All the code for the printing you need to write over here. Everyone has to write this. So now if some employee is going to leave the company, I don't have any problem. The other programmer don't need to read the entire project. I just ask him or her, okay, do one thing, something is problem with the print, check it out. Now T's don't need to go for this method and all, because everything is crystal clear. Like, okay, this is method is for import, this is for export, this is for, okay, this is the print. So T's only will go for the print, she will make the required changes over there and everything will get fine. So by the use of abstract class, what we can do, we can implement the standard nomenclature over there. We can implement the template. So abstract class is basically used for, it provides us method template or some standard method signature. This is what exactly the use of abstract class is.